Welcome to Auto Car News. Please like, comment and subscribe to get more videos. Here we are, 17 years after the millennium, creeping toward a driverless future discussed elsewhere in this issue. Robo cars will ask very little of us, only that we sit there and wait. After a few years of this, our driving skills are likely to atrophy like leg muscles in a cast. We'll all become as helpless as Miss Daisy, reliant on a robotic hook to drive us around. Except maybe that's not what's going to happen, because we just hopped into the cabin of a redesigned 2018 Accord and there's a manual gearbox with a leather wrap knob between the seats. That shifter shouldn't be there, not this far into the driverless century. It's almost like finding out that Cadillac offered a hand crank starter in 1959. Of course that didn't happen, but if the robots win and the computer-driven car dominates mobility, this family sedan with a manual will certainly confuse the fossil record. Naturally, we love it. Partially because a manual family sedan gives us hope that our enthusiasm might have a place in the future, but also because we've loved slamming Hondas into gear since the 1980s, and we'd like to continue doing so for at least a few more decades. Slick and precise, this 6-speed available only on sport trims provides a mechanical conduit between the car, the driver, and the 252 HP turbocharged 2.0-liter 4-cylinder. We recently tested a 2.0T Touring with the 10-speed automatic, which is a no-cost option on the sport trim. The 2.0-liter is new and closely related to the 306 HP 2.0-liter in the Civic Type R. It replaces the previous generation's 278 HP 3.5-liter V6 as the top-spec engine. Moving up to the 2.0-liter from the base 192 HP turbocharged 1.5-liter will require around $2,000 to $4,500 of your hard-earned grickles, depending on trim level.